Captain Falcon!
Now we've got losers finals here between Nackle and EG. Both these guys were knocked to losers by Robert.
Yeah, and it's been a little over a year since these two have played. They had a couple sets at Gamma last year and one at LTC last year. Nackle, great pressure on that edge guard there. Standard for EG there. Nice adjustment. Back throw from Kirby on Falcon can be pretty hard to deal with. Usually have to be pretty patient there. Oh, and he gets him with the gimmick. We saw Kiyoshi use that a lot at Smash Con.
Yeah.
And I think a lot of Kirbys are starting to pick it up.
Yeah, I know we saw Studstill do that a lot here at the last Kirbstomped. Maybe that was two Kirbstomped ago. But.
Yeah, and it makes you think, like, who started it first, Studstill or Kiyoshi?
Yeah. I know what Studstill would tell you for who started it first.
SKG, I'm sorry, EG trying to keep it close here, still only a stock behind. And when Kirby start crouching in this matchup, to me it tells me they know how to deal with Falcon. Crouch forces Falcon to use, you know, a lot of options that he doesn't really like using in neutral.
Yeah.
Great spacing from Nackle, but EG just pressuring him.
So hard for Falcon to get down low enough with those back airs. Or Kirby can kind of just duck under the grab sometimes too.
Yeah.
It's hard to get in close enough to do anything.
Great patience, gets that grab. Down air.
Shortens the combo with a really good drop by Nackle.
Good positioning. Make sure to land on stage even with that dare pressuring him. Why is the VG just running away the instant that he misses? Otherwise, Kirby gets a lot of free mileage there.
Nice. He was going for the gimmick there again. VG just outspacing it.
I guess it is a gimmick if it doesn't work twice, right? An even game after Nackle had a pretty good lead to start. Both kind of trying to force them a little away from center stage. Oh, what a pickup! And flow charted here, down into forward smash, gonna cover the landing.
Yeah, EG is just so smart there, just waiting for Kirby to get back on stage. And knew he had to feel confirmed, just had to be patient enough.
Yeah, you don't.
It's really
don't
hard to not just
there, right?
Drop off and attack.
Yeah.
The guy back on stage.
And some Falcons, they try to rush it, and they'll get caught by that up B, and the Kirby can just turn it right around there. So I believe it is. There we go. And EG just slowly walking.
He uses to go under the edge over there. Under the side plat on there. So.
I'm thinking he's waiting for Wispy to blow, so the frame rate goes down a little bit. Throws off Nackle, a technical player. Oh, and that DI. We've seen it before, but still always good. EG is really weaselly with his movement here, and Nackle doing a good job pressuring him.
Come on.
All you need is that one hit of forward air to turn that into a stop. And he gets him with the day one.
Zero there. I don't think he wanted that jump on that.
EG, but I don't even think he was really trying to hit him with those back airs, but he was just forcing him low enough to where he could deal with the edge guard a little easier.
Yeah. That ledge hog was super smooth too. It was at the end after Nackle was already dead, essentially.
Yeah. So Nackle, despite all that, Nackle up 3-1 here. But he should be a stock. Both of them flexing their walking abilities.
I think this is the first time we've been in neutral where somebody had damage. Every stock this game has just been like, somebody gets a hit and it's a death.
Nice wait there for BG. Again. Probably accidental.
Yeah. I would think he was maybe trying to tap jump up air there. Just rushed it a little bit.
Somehow survives there. And next we take game two.
Even it up here. This game's winner is... immediately under that side plat.
Yeah, EG switching it up, moving to top plat,
right? I think these guys must have watched a Boomin' album at Smash Con. Yeah, Ecru Phoenix, the medals were from the remix bracket that we did as a side event. So it's the top four finishers all got the Smash Remix medals.
So something I like from EG there, he kind of waits for his opponent to sometimes jump in neutral and they'll try to scoop him with that up air when they're at mid percent. A nice little conversion there. Nackle's doing a great job just punishing EG's landings and just keeping the pressure on. How did that kill? Catches the landing with that forward air. Just slowly pressuring him, but Nackle doing a good job just defending himself in the corner.
Yeah, that was a really dangerous nair there, just kind of floating in.
And Nackle just comfortable just throwing out the bears here. Doesn't quite work out for him though. Nackle's caught him with that a lot, kind of baiting where EG might be able to down air him, and he just pivots forward smash. Kind of a day one Kirby option, but really good usage for it here.
Yeah, he's really good at reading the tech chases for that forward smash.
Mm-hmm. I almost never see him choose wrong on it.
Yeah. And you always see him just kind of, you know, single dashing across the stage when he's got a tech chase, just ready for forward smash in either direction.
Oh, perfect land there. Good pressure here. Nackle low on jumps.
Nackle
great just patience.
Under that forward smash.
Oh,
oh my god.
A little egregious there for that edge guard. I think a little more patience and he takes that game. Like, it is super tempting to hit that back air because
yep.
it can trade with that forward air. But, you know, when you're exhausting your double jump for it, it's not really worth it. Nackle catches him slipping a little bit. Doesn't get anything off of it though. It's a few percent.
Yeah, it can be really hard to just sit there, and try to wait for your opponent. I mean, if you're sitting, a lot of times you can just get, you know, out of the flow. I just always feel like it's harder to react from doing nothing to what your opponent's doing, to like, you know, moving around, spacing, trying to react to that.
Yeah, you don't want to get them comfortable doing nothing, you know?
Right.
Which is a weird thing to say, but some players, I think they respond better the more their opponent's moving. Great DI. Both these players just kind of crazy with their DI. EG with a nice stock lead here. As we've seen, it can change in a flash though. I like that he's a little more aggressive with his up smashes this game too. A little risky, but he can get so much off of it.
FDI for real. Guessing he didn't want that forward air there. He's in a good spot to just keep up airing.
Nice adjustment from Nackle, just a shield jump in there. Hard to say if the invincibility on the jump helped him out, but it never hurts to try.
Great tech chasing there on the platform. The shield pressure.
And again, just evening it up. Nackle more than willing to take that trade, what would have been just a stock down otherwise.
That could be EG's tournament stock now. Get that uphill. Great try though.
Oh, let's see what he can do with this though. Catches his jump.
Got that jump out, but still not enough to escape. Just with the edge guard.
Officer tech in place. Knowing you can DI that F air.
Not a good spot for him here.
Oh, reads the roll, but just
under.
Misses. That roll is vulnerable for one frame. You're just a little off. EG with the crowd behind him, trying to stay alive, force it to a game five. He's in a good position here.
That should do
and
it.
And that's gonna do it!
And the pop off from the crowd.
Great set as always from these two. They always play so close. I think their styles mesh like very well for competitive play.
I had to change the song there.
So Big Red's off to play double, so we got some solo commentary for 10 seconds. nice switch around from EG there. And great use of that top platform to continue that combo, but Nackle with very wise up D I to end the combo early. And that low hit of the back air. And EG didn't deal with that quite as well as he did in the past with perhaps a jump up down air. Not sure what EG's looking for here. I know what Nackle's looking for. An up tilt will do. And a nice nair, just stuffing that approach and turns it into a quick edge guard. Two stocks, or up two stocks here. Oh, an awesome use of that up B, just pressuring Kirby in the corner, really nowhere for him to go. Nackle with a bit of a flop there at 0%. EG can't really threaten much though.
What a duck.
Oh, and that DI just turns it into an up smash. And again, just turning around what Nackle would have a combo and great stock. EG just trying to maintain center stage. Nackle doing a good job just pressuring him in the corner. I think that's where Kirby really succeeds in this matchup. Oh, an incredible check chase, just... really great use of those dash attacks there. Snatches him from the ledge. And EG just really good at timing an attack in place. And now we have a last stock scenario, game five here from these two. EG and Nackle, who will have the privilege to play Robert. And Nackle with first blood here. Oh, and rough ending from EG, but I like what I saw from both of the opponents there.
Still a very good game five, don't you say?
I'd say it was a great game five. Great set overall from those two. I might have to step off to go play doubles here because we're a little behind. I was glad to hop on for a set though, so take care everyone.
Free for all! Kirby!